Mommy Veeral, and today we're gonna learn about dinosaurs. Do you guys like dinosaurs? Whoever likes dinosaurs, can you please raise your hand? Oh, I can see some kids raising their hands. Do you guys like dinosaurs? Yeah, me too. I like dinosaurs. But before starting, I have to show you this. What is this? What is it written? Dinosaurs. This is a book. But there is something inside this book that I really want to show you before we do anything else. All right. So let's see what is this. Can you guys guess what is inside this? What is this? It's a dinosaur. Look at this. How is this? This is a dinosaur which had a really long neck. Can you see how big the neck is of this dinosaur? See it closely. Yeah, some dinosaurs were so tall and they had this really huge neck. And do you know what they used to do? They used to stand on one place and eat the whole forest. Just by standing at one place and using their long neck, they could eat the whole forest for breakfast. Really, for breakfast. Like, can you guys eat the whole forest for your breakfast? No, right? Even I can't do it. But dinosaurs, like this, could do it. So the dinosaurs which could eat trees, leaves, and grass, they were called herbivores. What were they called? Herbivores. Herbivores were the dinosaurs like this. Stegosaurus. Yeah, this is a Stegosaurus. So Stegosaurus is one kind of a herbivore dinosaur who could eat leaves of the tree, they could eat plants, they would eat grass, and that's why we call them herbivores. Can you repeat with me? Herbivores. Alright, so that is one type of dinosaur. Now, do you want to see one more from this book? Yeah, I really want to show you something because it's so good, right? It's a good. There were other type of dinosaurs. Look at this. Guess who's this? Can somebody guess? T-Rex! Yeah, it's a T-Rex! Look at this! The teeth, the claws. So these were the dinosaurs. So like this, these were the dinosaurs who would eat other dinosaurs. Yeah, these dinosaurs would eat other dinosaurs and they were called carnivores. Can you repeat with me? Carnivores. No, they're not gonna eat you. Dinosaurs are no more. So it's just a picture, okay? It's just a picture. It's just a picture book. I love it. Alright, so this T-Rex would eat other dinosaurs. So they were called carnivores. Like, this is a Velociraptor. Velociraptor used to run so fast, like before you could even see it, they would be like gone. So this is a Velociraptor who would eat other dinosaurs. Some dinosaurs would eat dead animals, like dead dinosaurs. Some would eat alive dinosaurs. So they were meat eaters. They were called carnivores. Ah! Oh my god. Was it gonna eat me? No, right? It's just a toy. I was just kidding. Okay. Herbivores, carnivores. And then there were dinosaurs who would eat both plants and animals. Like both they would eat. Whatever they find, they will eat it. Yeah, if they find plant, they'll eat plants. If they find animals, they will eat animals. They were called omnivores. Few examples of omnivores could be Oviraptor. Oviraptor would be one of the omnivores dinosaur. Now, okay, look around and see, do you see any dinosaurs around you? Yes or no? No, right? You don't see any dinosaurs around you because there are no more dinosaurs. They used to live millions of years ago, right? So how do we know about dinosaurs? There would be someone who would be studying the fossils of dinosaurs. Fossils of dinosaurs means, like, let's say this dinosaur got extinct, right? They were no more, but when they died, there were rock and sand and all the things came above them. They were, their fossils, their remains were stored in rocks, all right? So there is one kind of person who's called paleontologist. What they would do is that they would dig up the fossils and they would see, hey, it's a dinosaur, it's a velociraptor. So the people, the person who would study about dinosaur, their fossils, they are called paleontologists. What are they called? Paleontologists. Okay, now I'm going to tell you, where did the dinosaurs go? Like, they used to live here for so many years. There were so many of them, but where did they go? I'm going to show you a small video, alright? And then you will see from that science experiment what happened and where did the dinosaurs go. Okay, so hold on, and I'm going to put this video, alright? And so you will know where did they go. Alright, so see this video. Let's start. Hi guys, today we are going to do a volcano science experiment and see where did the dinosaurs go. To make a mountain, we are going to put glass on a plate and surround it with sand. Alright, now let's start the dinosaur volcano science experiment. What is that, Dion? Millions of years ago, dinosaurs lived on Earth. But one day, a big meteor came into Earth. Then there were volcanoes, fire and smoke everywhere. Sunlight could not come in, so all the plants and dinosaurs died. Yeah, the volcano is going to reach the dinosaurs. And because the volcano is so hot, all the dinosaurs are sadly going to get burned in this volcano.
See, Mama, all the dinosaurs died.
Yeah. How did the dinosaurs die, Dian?
Because they were no sunlight.
Oh.
Then there was no food, then there was one thing, they wrapped, and then they died.
I see you. So, did you guys see how did the dinosaurs go? Yeah, so what happened was, let's make a fist like this. Alright, let's assume this is Earth, okay? What is this? Earth. Earth is a planet where we all live, okay? So, what happened was that on Earth, a big meteor came. Can you do like this with me? Huh? Can you guys do it? Okay. So on Earth, a big meteor came and it did boom, boom. What did it do? Boom. when the big meteor came on Earth, there were a lot of volcanoes on Earth. When there were volcanoes, what happened? Can you do like this? Fire! There was fire everywhere. Because of the fire, what happened? There was so much smoke in the clouds, right? You know it, right? When there is a lot of fire, there is smoke in the clouds. When there was so much smoke in the cloud, what happened? Sun could not come in. I mean, the sunlight could not come inside Earth. But we all know that we need oxygen, right? Like, can you breathe in with me? Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. So what did you breathe in? Oxygen, right? So even dinosaurs would need oxygen back then, right? So the dinosaurs could not have oxygen because the sunlight and the thick smoke clouds would not let the sunlight come through. So all the plants, they died. Because plants need sunlight, right? So all the plants died. Now when the plants died, this dinosaur, who is the plant eating dinosaur, he also died, right? Because he could not eat plants. Now when this happened, the Velociraptor would eat other dinosaurs, he also died. So all the dinosaurs died, and that's how we don't see any more dinosaurs anymore. But tell me one thing, if dinosaurs were alive today, let's suppose, okay, if dinosaurs were alive today, would you be happy or scared? Tell me, what would you be, happy or scared? Okay. Do you guys want to know what I would be? Happy or scared, what would I be? Do you want to know that? Okay. I think I would be... I think I would be happy. Yeah, I think I would be happy with a little bit of scared. You know why? Because I would be happy that I was able to see such big dinosaurs, right? Big dinosaurs like Brachiosaurus. But I would be so scared. Why? Would you guess it? Because I would think like, oh, dinosaur like Velociraptor could come and eat me. I think I would feel both. Yeah, I think I'm a little confused. I think I would be feeling both. But anyways, you got this point, all right? Herbivore, carnivore, omnivore, paleontologist, and where did the dinosaurs extinct? Where did the dinosaurs go? Now you know it. All right. So now we are moving on to craft. I have two cute dinosaurs. Do you guys want to make a craft like this with me? Okay. This one I did with paper plate, but I'm going to show you how you can do it with paper. All right. So can you guys bring a paper with you? Let's start the craft. Dino craft. Draw a pattern like this and cut it into pieces. Draw a semicircle and cut it. Now when you cut the papers like this, take the semicircle and apply glue on the back side of it like this. Now stick one by one the neck of the dinosaur, back plates of the dinosaur, the tail, and the four legs of the dinosaur. Then make a paper eye and glue it on the dinosaur. Look how easy it is, and so quickly you can make your own dinosaur. I enjoyed so much in the class today. Thank you guys for coming to the dino class. Let us all do roar together, okay? 3, 2, 1, roar! Can you? Let's do it again, okay? 3, 2, 1, roar! So subscribe to the channel Mommy Veeral so that you will not miss a single class and you will be learning about different things. Next time, I'm gonna teach you about occupations. Yeah, like different kinds of occupations are there. I'm gonna show you the different types of occupation. Alright, so see you in the next class. Bye-bye. Say bye, Mommy Veeral. Bye, my friends. See you next time. Thank you for coming. Subscribe to the channel. Ta-da! Mommy Veeral and Diane.